Two camps, both alike in dignity.
In fair Princeton, where we lay our scene.
From the opening moments of Jane Wilson's narration, an obvious homage to Shakespeare, we, as viewers, realize that we are in for something much more than just a Chapin film. The original idea for BRAVESCHOOL was conceived 2 years ago, during a rainy day at Chapin's summer camp. Creators Ben Bickford and Rob Tregler, both fans of Braveheart and the Lord of the Rings trilogy, had always talked about filming an epic battle scene, but they had no plot.
Well, it started off as, I guess almost like a joke between Rob and I about how it would be funny if we did something like this, and it started off as a trailer. There was a really rainy day at camp, and I was outside doing lacrosse camp, and Rob was doing video camp, and we did a Braveheart / Lord of the Rings battle scene.
And we said, let's take some umbrellas and some cameras out in the rain and just film a muddy battle scene. But the weird thing is, when you look at that old trailer, you can't even tell it's raining, and it was pouring. The kids got soaked with mud. It was just a lot of fun.
Kids just had so much fun doing it. We had so much fun doing it. We came up with, you know, that we should try to turn it into a movie. And
that idea was turned into a popular 2-minute trailer without a name. The idea for the title came from 8-year-old Jack Tregler after the trailer was completed.
We just finished watching the first trailer with the battle scenes. And they were wondering what to call it, and I was half asleep, and I just said BRAVESCHOOL, and my dad thought it was a good name, so that's how he came up with it.
It did start off as, like, we just wanted to do the huge Hollywood epic sweeping battle, and then the storyline had to come out of that.
We originally wanted the school to be a castle, and we realized we couldn't do that, so we just had, why don't we just go regular school with a king who runs around, he's kind of psychotic and thinks he's a king, but he's the only one wearing the wardrobe.
Why are you talking to me? Why is he talking to me?
My character is the king, it's the principal or head of the school who has this fantasy that he's this great and powerful king.
Well, when Ben and I were writing the screenplay, I wanted John Halleck immediately because he's just got the king sideburns, he has that presence.
On action.
What?
That's good. Give me a second one. Action.
What?
Good. I'll definitely.
Bickford and I said we have to come up with a script idea that's going to support having a big battle at the end. So we started hashing out ideas. What can these two camps be angry about with each other to push them to the point of battling on the field?
There's a lot of different storylines because we kept just coming up with storylines. Stacy, Macy, and Tracy having to, you know, go into the classroom and steal stuff just started off as a storyline.
Stacy, Macy, and Tracy, and like they're like best friends, and they're always together, and they wear pink.
Our job was to go get the lacrosse stick out of the BLC office. There it is.
The kid who doesn't really want to be in lacrosse camp, I think is actually the first one we did, Noah's character, talking about how he didn't want to be in lacrosse camp and really just wanted to be a video kid. That was one of the first storylines that we created.
Well, my character was kind of a klutz throughout the whole movie. You know, there's a couple scenes in the movie of me dropping.
And then by the movie, it ends up just being a very small part, not the driving force in the Romeo and Juliet story between Billy and Julie ends up being the main driving force.
And that's how the script develops. So it's basically one entire script to support a battle.
The producers knew that they would have to cast several adults in lead roles to give the film some credibility and also to bring up the level of student performances.
Look, Percival, I don't know what kind of game your father
is. No, Mr. Trevor, it is you that is playing the game.
But they had no idea how auspicious the casting of Gil Olvera would be.
Ah! you know, these movies are so hard. I mean, because you have kids that aren't particularly experienced in acting, and teachers too, and you're just, you know, going out there. I mean, I think that Gil's character ended up better than anyone could have said ahead of time.
Would you look at those video camp pansies with their props and cameras?
Warmed up to that character and just made, he got so many laughs with the different things he did. He just was hilarious. And
action.
So how do you think the first day went? Think we got a shot?
We have a shot? That cream puff Tregler and his...
Coach Olvera really loved lacrosse and it was his life, and was not about to let the film school nerds get the best of them.
But I love lacrosse. You do that now.
Which was interesting to watch a, you know, much smaller coach kind of shove around Mr. Bickford.
Not to be outdone by their adult counterparts, many students delivered strong performances in supporting roles, most notably Chris Litauer's performance as Ian, Brave School's villain.
I mean, there's so many good performances. I'm especially happy with Chris Litauer's performance as the bad guy. I think people that have seen the film and don't know Chris think that he is actually that mean, and he's just a sweetheart, you know.
I was mainly thinking about just trying to think of some macho jock type of guy who just didn't have any feelings or any sensitivity at all and was just completely focused on sports.
Really? Well, guys, you signed off. Let's go. It's the field.
Let's go, man. Let's go.
Producers had an interesting challenge filling the other student roles.
Well, I play Freddy, and he is a double agent who sneaks into lacrosse camp, and he's actually trying to get information for the video.
Well, I play Adam. He's kind of a nerd, technology geek kid, and, you know, he's like Mr. Tregler's right-hand man, and, you know, he does all the technical stuff for him.
So what'd you find out, Freddy?
And I originally wrote the part of the King's Son for Mark Eder, who graduated last year, and when he wasn't able to come to camp, I took a look at Gabe Siciliano, and I screen tested him as well, and Bickford and I both agreed that he'd be perfect for the role.
Well, Percival's, he's the King's Son, and he just goes around and bothers everybody. I personally think he's just trying to get attention. Joyous news! Father's eliminating one of the camps!
The role of Montvale, his assistant, was actually created for David Sharp.
I was pretty much Percival's lackey, and that was pretty fun, because he had this big, huge, elegant cape, and I had this little, tiny, short one.
Wouldn't you like to know?
I play Andrew, and that's Mr. Tregler's kind of like second in command, sidekick guy who, like, you know, goes with him everywhere, and he helps him with, like, the camera and stuff like that.
Some of the kids really impressed me. Some are really, really talented.
Well, Mr. Bickford approached me during the study hall to audition for this part. So after lacrosse practice one day, I came in and auditioned for Mr. Tregler, and I got the part.
I'd never seen her act. She hadn't been in any Chapin films, but she just had that innocent look that I wanted for the role, so we screen tested her.
Two, wait. What? Go. That's your, are you on action? For the role of Billy, many actors were considered, but 8th grader Chris Tenev eventually won the part, despite having concerns about his character's unlikable nature.
Billy's sort of I don't really like his character.
In the original version of the script, the character of Billy survived his injuries. But the creators made a last-minute decision to add a narration at the end in which he does not.
And so, with Billy's passing, the two camps were allowed to remain.
As I said before, I didn't really like Billy, and so I guess it was a cool way to wrap up the story.
Perhaps the crown jewel of the film is the epic battle scene, which was filmed over 2 days in upper 90 degree heat.
They were hard, you know, there was parts of it that are really hard, but the kids actually had a lot of fun with it. We used two cameras, and we would have the kids pair up and come up with some idea to do together. And then we went around and filmed them, so we had lots of background action going on.
Background action! Go! Action!
Scott Ball!
The battle scenes were just long and it was hot out there. And it was a lot of doing the same, moves over and over, and it was a lot harder than I thought, because you have kids coming at you and you're trying to fake fight in the background and trying to look busy when you're probably not even gonna be in the real shot at the end.
Action! Whoa! Action!
So we scheduled the battle scenes for Thursday and Friday of that week. The kids couldn't wait. When are the battle scenes coming? So we waited for the last 2 days to shoot the battle scenes. And from day one, Bickford and I's best safety was most important. We didn't want anyone hurt.
Shit. Ho, 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 ho. Not that hard. Jesus.
I'm not touching your hand.
They took a long time. Like, the last one took us most of the day.
Action.
It was pretty hard, faking falling and stuff, but it was fun.
Action! 2, 1, action. 2, 1, and action. Nice.
I thought it was pretty easy if we just listened to what Mr. Traegler and Mr. Bickford told us to do.
I don't think they were that difficult, because all we did was kind of run around and hit each other, and so it was pretty fun.
Many people believe that BRAVESCHOOL was filmed completely on location, when actually all of the special effects were done here at Treg Film Studio.
When you look at the film, it doesn't look like there are a lot of special effects, but actually there are a lot of effect shots in the movie.
For example, if you look at this raw footage shot of the aerial attack, you'll notice that you don't see any balls in the air. So we had to create a digital lacrosse ball, put it on a green screen, and put a motion on it, and do that several times over to at least make it look like balls are in the air. On this next shot, we told Danny to fake like he was bouncing balls off of the film reel.
Three, here they come, here they come. Get ready to deflect it now. That's good.
And then we had to digitally put those in to exactly land off the film reel, add sound effects, and here's what the two final shots look like.
Fire!
Editors worked around the clock for weeks on end to finish all of these special effects.
It's done yet?
Since we didn't have all that many lacrosse players, we knew that a charge across the field wouldn't look convincing with just 12 guys. So we had them line up, staying on one side of an invisible line, and charge towards the camera.
Charge!
We then had them go to the other side, maintaining the line, meld the two shots together, and this is the final result.
Charge!
Trex, you done yet?
And you two react to him getting hit, and that's when you take off into the woods. Alrighty, three.
And finally, for the shot of David getting hit by the film reel, we had his co-actors react to him getting hit, green screened a film reel into the shot, and tried to make it look like it bounces off his head.
Tensions mounted as the premiere date approached.
Is it done yet?
And a first for any Chapin film, Mr. Traegler actually received written permission from composer Brian Tyler to use his work from the movie timeline for BRAVESCHOOL.
I'm really glad that he gave us permission, because I think this music does wonders for the film. And I just think it's great that it's one filmmaker helping out another.
I think it's a really fun movie, and all the kids involved in it can feel really proud about it.
I think it turned out great.
I saw the original, the rough cut, a while back. I think it's going to be great. how you guys did some of those battle scenes beyond me. They're pretty realistic.
At first I thought it was kind of corny, but when it comes together, I think it actually turned out really nicely, and it's a good movie.
I thought it turned out really great. Definitely better than I thought it was going to be.
I think it's turned out great.
I definitely like being out there, having a big role. That was nice.
It turned out great. It's funny, all the characters are great. The kids did a great job. I was really impressed with the kids acting, actually, especially the main characters.
The kids really had a great experience making the film.